So I moved home about a month, month and a half ago. I spent the first three, 4 weeks just kind of holed up in my apartment. I always hate people stereotyping depressive episodes. Like, it's not all agoraphobia and suicide attempts. I mean, I kind of was, but I had a rough couple of months. Year, whatever. In hindsight, I understand quitting my meds cold turkey, probably not the greatest idea. I mean, I don't really remember much. I mean, 1 second I'm working at a Starbucks on La Cienega, and then the next thing I know, I'm splashing hot coffee on some asshat from the valley.
Oh, what the fuck!
You got a free drink, deal with it, it's on the house.
Who insisted on ordering a goat milk latte. And then I knocked over a rack of cups, which is like, we're talking about Starbucks cups here.
How the hell are we still having a quarter shortage?
That's like $300 in mug retail. And then I'm taking bites out of every single pastry behind the glass display, and I don't know if you've ever worked at Starbucks before, but all of those pastries in the display are made of cardboard. Is it just blacked the whole thing out of my mind, you know? Like a screw in my mind just came loose. I don't really know. All I know is they've banned me from every Starbucks for the remainder of my natural life, and that's when I was forced to move back home. Force is a strong word. Strongly encourage. Yeah. And they put me back on my meds again. Stronger dose this time. Which is weird, because it's not at all like it is in the movies, you know? Like I'm still capable of feeling emotions. I'm not like a potato with great hair, you know? It's hard to explain. I feel like I'm cut off from something inside of me. Like, all the feelings are still there. They're just not like in the back of my throat, like all the time. I think I just got used to being an emotional trainer. I don't really know what I'm supposed to be. I'm sorry, I totally forgot the question.
I asked why you would be a good addition to our team.
Right!